was 5 years old, I declared to my mom and all of her friends that I was going to be the prime minister of Sweden when I grew up. I've not been that yet, and neither has any Swedish woman ever in Sweden, the most gender equal country in the world. When I was about 8, I got my hands on this picture. It's a collector's card, global garbage pail kids, something like that, where kids look really, really weird and you collect them. And I got my hands on this one and I loved it because it was a picture of me. It was me with the ponytails and the pink dress. And also me, the strongest girl, the one who can climb, the one who loves to wrestle. Yay, I love it, I said. And I went up to my teacher and I showed it to her. And she said, oh, kids, this picture shows that girls are in one way and boys are in another. And that is something that has never worked for me, of course. Those gender roles, those stereotypical pictures of who should be doing what, and also the effect that has on gender equality and the way we reproduce those stereotypes in media every day. And I'm working with that, and I've been doing that for almost 17 years in different ways. And talking about gender equality, as I said, I did not become the prime minister. I started working with PR instead. And with PR, media is one of my biggest areas, my biggest fields. Gender equality is a huge, huge measurable thing in media. And one piece of important information comes here. Gender equality is not a matter of opinions. It is a matter of knowledge and facts. In Sweden, many papers, media loves to measure gender equality by going out asking Swedes, do you think that Sweden is a gender equal country? And perhaps 55% of the men say, yeah. 37% of the women say, yes, it is. And I would like to say you are not measuring gender equality in Sweden by asking if they think Sweden is a gender equal country. You are measuring the huge lack of knowledge when it comes to this issue. Gender equality is not a matter of feelings or opinions. It is something you can measure. It's something you can count. It's facts. When it comes to salary, when it comes to unpaid work at home, when it comes to violence, all of these things, there are reports on it. So please bear that, take that with you. Don't let anyone get away with declaring that they think or feel that something is gender equal. Count. Use facts. And counting is something that I have done a lot of. About counting and media. 76% of everyone in news media all over the world today is men. 80% of the experts in news media today, all over the world, are male. You can find all these numbers in a report called Global Media Monitoring Report. And you smart people are thinking, wait a minute, we're right now in Sweden, the most gender equal country in the world. These numbers might not at all correlate with Sweden. Oh, yes, they do. 7 out of 10 in our biggest, one of our biggest dailies, Dagens Nyheter, DN.se counted 7 out of 10, and their articles are men. Journalists, their job is to portray society and us in the society. And what do they think about this achievement? This is what they think. Aidan White, the former head of International Federation of Journalism, he said that they're failing to portray fairly more than half of the human population. And I'd say, no, sorry, Aidan. 100% of the human population, of course. We're not 76% men on this earth. Expertise is not given in a bigger piece to men. This is a huge democracy problem, of course. If media is not getting all the different experience that we in society have, and we're supposed to go and go to the ballots and choose our government based on what we read in the magazines and not everyone's view upon our society is shown there. Huge democracy problem. And why is this? I mean, these people are not stupid. These are smart journalists, smart media people who really, really want to portray the society as it is. I'm really not thinking that these journalists think that this TV show is better with mostly men in it, or perhaps some do, but I'm hopefully not everyone. This is not the way they want it to be. How come it is this way? Again, the stereotypes. Who should be doing what? If 80% of the experts we've seen on TV, heard on radio, read about in magazines have been men, of course we're going to go look for men, even if you're a journalist. Talking to parents, perhaps you're more prone to talking to a woman. All of those stereotypes, you're reproducing them and making our possibilities to live fully, with our fully potential, lesser. 3 years ago, I was having a blast. I was at this gala, and I was counting. As I said, counting knowledge, facts, a huge key to, one, start talking about these problems, two, doing something about them. I was at a gala, and I was counting who was on stage. The presenter, they were giving away awards for theater, best restaurant, best song, best album, best whatever. And I was counting everyone giving away the prizes, receiving the prizes, etc. And I was tweeting. At the end of the gala, 48 men had been on stage, 7 women. And afterwards, the producer, a friend of mine, came up and said, Lina, you are such a pain in the ass. You're such a pain in the ass. You know I'm not like that. And also we had a woman, but she got sick. Okay. And I said, but why? If you really, really did not want this gala to be like this, why did we end up like this? And he used the most common excuse there is. We really wanted them, but we couldn't find them. Adding on some, she was sick or she just didn't show up or whatever. We couldn't find them. And this is something really, really interesting. Just couldn't find them. And I said, okay, can I help? Perhaps next year, when you're trying to figure out who you're going to put on this stage, perhaps I could be of help. When you can find a comedian who's a white man, I'll find you 10 others. For the wine connoisseur, the theater boss, whatever, you can find one, I'll find you 10 others. I'll find you 10 women who could also be on stage. You can choose just the way you want, the person you want, but I'll just help you find the others, if that's the problem. And I really think that he felt that I was annoying. And he went away, and I said, oh my God, made myself one more enemy. And then he came back with a bottle of champagne. And he put it on the table, and he said, Lina, let's do this. Let's do this. And something happened. Something with this knowledge and counting and adding some help. And all of a sudden, he was like, yay, let's do this. So I drank the bottle of champagne. And I moved on. I moved on to a nightclub down in Stockholm. And I was talking to the nightclub owner. And I said, how come I've never seen a girl DJ here? Only guys, every night. And he was like, no, we actually had a woman DJing a few months ago. But it didn't really turn out as we planned. It was just she played too much rock music. I'm like, oh, that's so funny. How come that never, ever applies to a man? A man who doesn't turn out exactly the way you thought it would be. I mean, you've never said that about the American presidents. It didn't turn out the way you thought it could be, so really shouldn't try a man again. And then it was like, oh, but you know, it's also about technical skills. You really have to be good at technical skills. And I'm like, wait a minute. The two guys DJing right now, they work in a jeans store. They push play and pause. My grandma could do that. How come the girl who might enter has to be at this level, but the ones already in does not? And after a while, we sort of agreed, and he said, yeah, we would really love some girl DJs. Of course I know that would make this nightclub a better nightclub. And I said, okay, let me help. And remember, I have had the bottle of champagne. Let me help. I'll find you 100 DJs who are not men by Monday morning. And he said, yes, and I said, yes, and we high-fived, and we had a blast. And I woke up the morning. I don't even think it was the morning after. I think it was the morning after that I woke up. And I panicked, of course. 100 DJs? I don't know 100 DJs. I really don't know 100 DJs who are girls. But I promise him and I find them. And I remember this lovely picture that I saw on the internet. that said, don't panic, organize. And I've been working with social media for about 10 years, seeing people from different areas of the world, different ages, different genders, different class, background, etc., connecting around an idea, something that they wanted to create. People adding just their piece of information or their view into this bigger picture and really making a difference. So I went to my computer. I registered a Facebook page. I called it Rättviseförmedlingen, which would be something like Equality Agency. And I wrote, hi, we're Rättviseförmedlingen. We're going to help all of you who can't find other than men for your expert panels, your interviews, your DJ booths, your history books. We'll help you find other than women who could talk about raising kids, about gender equality, etc. Here we are, it's totally free, ask us. Hi! And I published it, and I went to grab a cup of tea. I came back, and 200 people had joined. 200 people joined my little Facebook page and said, yay, let's do this, woo, fun! Okay, I said, and I posted the first search. We're going to help the nightclubs of Sweden find DJs who aren't men because they really want them, but they can't find them. Do you know any? Someone posted a name, Marimba Roni, graded R&B, Sissy Moon, Superhouse DJ. And the next morning at 10 o'clock, I could send him this list. 130 names. I think this is a round of applause time. What? 130 names of DJs who are not men. And I just want to mention a few things. These are not better DJs than the ones the nightclubs already knew. But they're not worse either. Because what you do when you unintentionally exclude people from a context based on gender or skin color, and then declare that over here we only care about competence and quality, you are actually saying that the others lack competence and quality. And how would you know? You have never tried them. How would you know? What did we learn? They do exist, and help helps. So this list of 130 DJs was all of a sudden available for all the nightclubs in Sweden who said, yay, we can make better nightclubs. That's fun. The ball started rolling. 200 people, became 500 people, 1,000, 2,000. We started posting searches every day, two a day, three a day. The lists grew and grew. We were searching for magicians, for TV shows, magicians who weren't men in suits sawing women in bikinis into two parts, or perhaps motor experts, or we searched for men who were in this like knitting conference. The list grew and grew and grew, and what was really fascinating is that they grew within the feeds of everyone who was in the group. Anyone who liked saw these lists grow and had their stereotypical view of who should be doing what twisted. New added, new values added. We have found web programmers. We have found math professors. We have found football hooligans, film photographers, boxing experts. The lists, they grow every day. And every of these lists change our view of who should be doing what. The results? More than 700 searches. More than 20,000 names collected onto the list that we save. More than 51,000 ambassadors. And no more excuses, because of course they exist. And of course we should not be missing out on that part of competence, be it men who are also parents, or be it women who are experts in Egypt or math, or be it someone in a wheelchair or someone whose skin color isn't the same as mine. Media loves us. Media loves what we do. They've been writing a whole lot about us. And of course they should. I mean, we make them do a better job. And we do it for free. Whenever they try to like come up with good persons for an interview, perhaps someone before had said, oh, we only found 10 experts on digital business who are men because there weren't any women who... And all of a sudden, 50,000 people are there to prove them wrong. So either they contact us, we post a search, and anyone could add names and they get a list of 300 people to call. Some names they might not even have heard before, and they might be hard for them to say, or they don't even know who the person is, but perhaps this is a way for them to try. Or they could do the job themselves, because 50,000 people are there to encourage them. We want you to do this. We want you to change the stereotype of who should be doing what. But does it really make a difference? All the lists that 50,000 people are creating every day in our tiny little Facebook group that I started one hungover morning 3 years ago, does it make a change? I mean, for the girl who is 5 years old and wants to become a prime minister, or perhaps the boy who occasionally wants to wear a dress, or for any kid who wants to have more possibilities than just the ones given today, does it really make a change? I actually didn't know. And this is a non-profit project. This is something that has taken a whole lot of non-sleeping nights and a whole lot of effort, making all these people, no matter what political view, come together and sort of agree upon, yeah, I'm going to add a few names onto this list. I think media will be better if it's not only men who are experts, or perhaps if some people's skin color doesn't look the same as mine. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. I can add a few names, but does it make a difference? Let me introduce you to Malla and Elvin. These are my brother's kids. 2 years ago, I got over to my brother's house. Late night, I was tired. I'd been working as a dog with this project. It's hard to talk about gender equality, diversity today, because talking about the problem, you're often perceived as the one creating the problem. We did not have a problem until you started counting. This was a fantastic gala until you came up holding out these numbers. Stop creating problems. That is something that you need to remember while you talk about these things. You're often perceived as the one creating the problems, but the problems are there anyway. So you just might as well spread the knowledge and talk about the problems. Anyway, I was tired. I came home to Malla and Elvin. We sat on the sofa. We were watching a Swedish TV kids show called Folkoteket. It's where kids follow grown-ups to work. And this day, it was a helicopter called Elisabeth. And when Malla saw the helicopter Elisabeth, helicopter pilot, she jumped off the sofa and said, I'm going to fly. I'm going to be a pilot. The helicopter pilot was found through our network. And you know what? Perhaps one day Malla will become a pilot, thanks to Elisabeth and 50,000 people wanting to create a change. Thank you very much for listening.